Who will it be? Mommy and G. Now, so for real, thank you guys for tuning in. This is our first video, first vlog of Mommy and G. So we're gonna have a bunch of things in store for you guys, like recipes. Of course, we're gonna do reviews on products we buy. Genesis, a lot of items that moms really should know if it's a buy or not, like if you're wasting your money or not. So today, this video is Genesis' first foods, yay! It's time for Genesis to eat solid foods. So the first solid foods I decided to make her is a strawberry, apple, and we have some bananas puree. And then I'm gonna make her another puree, which is gonna be raspberry, blueberries, and strawberries. So it's a little berry mix. So she's gonna have two choices this week. I'm gonna feed her these foods throughout the week for breakfast, and she can probably have them for lunch if she chooses to. I'm not sure how she's gonna, you know, eat the food, if she's gonna like it, if she's not. So we're gonna see. So all of this is new for us. Just welcome to our journey of Mommy and G. Okay. So to start off, I have some fresh raspberries and blueberries, like I showed you guys, some fresh strawberries. And I have some organic apples. Everything is organic. I'm choosing, of course, you know, to cook my food for Genesis, because I feel like in the grocery store, you never know what's really in the food. You know, most supermarkets, they have a bunch of preservatives and sugars that we don't want in the baby's food. So this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna make G's food at home so mommy knows what she's feeding baby. And baby knows what she's eating, right, G? Okay, so we're gonna get started. I have Genesis' stroller here with me, because she likes the little stroller. She be in the house with me in the stroller sometimes, but she just likes to see me for real. Like, she's content with seeing me, so. Cooking with Mommy and G, you ready, baby? Let's get it, GG. Let's get it, baby. Okay, Stinky. Thank you. Gave it a pussy. You ready? So, of course, first we want to take the fruits and we want to make sure we clean the fruits. Thoroughly clean them. Okay, so how I clean my fruits is I just take, you know, a strainer, pour the fruits in there. I don't know why I always rinse them off before I pour them in the strainer anyway. But I pour them in the strainer. The apples, I don't need to, well, I was reaching for the apples, but the apples I don't need to rinse because I'm going to peel the skin off the apples. So, this is, hey, mommy, what's up? What's up? Okay. So yeah, I'm rinsing off. Can't see it really good. I'm rinsing off the strawberries. Rinse it off with some cool water. You know, you just want to make sure they're nice and clean. You want to make sure they're nice and clean. I'm going to put them back in the bowl. And I would say for each of these purees, I read a recipe online. Okay, I'm back. I had actually put Genesis down for a nap. She didn't want to hang out with mommy, so hopefully by the time she wakes up, her food will be done so she gets to eat. So back to it, we're going to start cutting up the fruits. What I'm going to start with first is I'm going to start cutting up the strawberries. Here we go. When you're cutting the fruit, you want to cut them in smaller pieces, because the smaller the pieces are, the quicker it gets done when you put it on the oven to boil. So we're gonna do some tiny pieces. These aren't super tiny, but I feel like they're good size. And here we go. Of course, you wanna get rid of the top part. You wanna make sure that you're only giving the baby, you know, what's needed. So when I'm cutting strawberries, I like to make sure that I get, you know, the ripe, every little piece out. It's a little, I don't know if you guys can see, but it's a little green piece of the leaves that's still stuck on there. When I cut them, I like to make sure that whole area is smooth. So you're making sure you're only giving the baby all strawberry. Okay, so I'm done. I am finished cutting up all of the strawberries. Here we go. All of our strawberries. Okay, so next, the raspberries and the blueberries, they don't have to be cut up, so we're gonna keep them how they are. And next we're gonna move on to the apples. So today I'm gonna use 3 whole apples. I have another one in the bag, but I'm gonna use 3 whole apples. And these are Fuji organic apples. And I wish I had a peeler. I don't think I do. But if I had a peeler, I would peel these. Let me look. Somebody look at this. I got a peeler. So we're gonna start peeling our apples. I don't even honestly know where I got this. I didn't even know I had it. I like to put the apples down on a hard surface. It's easier for me to peel it. It's quicker. If there's any brown spots in the apple, I just like to, you know, clear it off. Just take a little bit off. Take a little bit of that skin off. That layer off to make sure it's all, you know, clear. And of course, once we peel the apple, after we are done peeling it, we are going to carve it out to make sure we don't have any seeds or stems or, you know, anything else that we don't want to have the baby take in. I can't believe this is a Mommy and G episode and she really went to sleep, y'all. This is crazy. All right, let me finish this. This is actually slipping, so what's this? This Faberware? Because you know if it's Faberware, them products really... they be cheap. They be working though. They do the job, but this one, I don't even know if it's favorite, but I'm talking trash. Okay, so I like to take my apples and I'm gonna cut them into 4s. And then once I cut them, of course, I'm gonna make sure I get all of the middle, the rind out, the seeds out, you know, clear it up. If there's any skinless, of course, you can just cut that off. Here's our apples. I hate, like, I wish I had, you know, I'm gonna get some devices that help me with this because I feel like I'm wasting so much of the fruits. Like when I'm cutting them and, you know, getting all the skin and the seeds out, I feel like I'm, and fruit is not expensive. I mean, and fruit is not cheap, but I really feel like I'm wasting some of the fruit, a lot of the fruit that Genesis could be eating, you know? I gotta find better ways to do this because I don't think this was, nah. It was okay for what I had today, but I'm going to invest in some things that help me with Genesis eating. Of course, oh, big thing I forgot to mention, y'all, we are using the magic bullet today. The baby magic bullet. So of course this is gifted to us. Oh, it's not even a baby magic bullet. I'm all calling the mag. You know, I know y'all know what I'm talking about with the magic bullet, but this is actually a baby bullet. Shout out to Jaleesha, Auntie Leash Leash. She got her this. So we're gonna be using that to puree the food. Gonna continue to peel these apples. Okay, I cut up all the apples, but I am gonna cut them up into smaller pieces. Like I told you guys, I feel like, well, I know for a fact, the smaller you cut the pieces, the faster the food cooks. So let's get it. Cutting these apples up real quick. Always be careful too, because I literally almost just chopped my finger off. I don't know if y'all seen that, but I almost just lost a finger. Literally. Okay, the apples are all cut up. I did cut them into little small pieces right here. I feel like this is a good size for the apples. Next, we have our bananas. I done ripped the banana off the vine all wrong and it looked like this, but let me tell y'all. When I was a kid, I never wanted to eat like the bananas when they look like this, but I was told that when they look like this, they have more nutrients. So we're gonna use this one. Of course, if it was like molded, not molded, but you know, like when it get real mushy, I wouldn't use it if it was that point. Like up here at this top of the banana, right here is mushy. You see, I'm not even like using that. Not even using none of this, just throwing that out. So I'm like stuck. I think I want to use, I mean, I think one banana is good. Yeah. Because, you know, it says the ingredients say one banana, but you know, we like doing our own stuff. All right, next. I have all the fruit cut up. Next, we are going to put it in a pot with a little bit of water, and we're going to simmer and cook it for about 7 to 10 minutes. The goal is to just make it soft. You don't want it super mushy, but you want it soft. Now I got a little pan that a little pot that I'm going to use to put the fruits in to cook them. So here's the strawberries. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cook it separately. So I'm going to do two different cooks. So right here, I'm starting with the strawberries. I'm going to use half of the strawberries for the strawberry apple banana puree. Here's the rest of the apples and the bananas. So I'll put that in the pot. Make sure we get all of that in there. We'll make sure there's no spots that we don't want going in the food, like the skin. You don't want to put the skin in there. You just peeled it off real quick. Now we have our bowls. Now we have our pot ready. We're going to add a little bit of water. So I'm going to add a little bit of water to the pot. Can't really even see it in there. You want just a little bit of water. So we have all of the fruits here on the stove. This is the strawberry, apples, and bananas. You do want to cover the fruit to actually, you know, help them cook faster. Keeps all the heat in. So let's see how long this takes. Put it in at 3:31. We'll see what time it is when I take it out. It smells so good. So it is sizzling. You want to stir it up while it's boiling. It is smelling so good in here right now. It smells like I'm baking a whole apple pie or something, and I'm not. It smells good, right? I believe this is done. These apples are very soft, just like I wanted them. We're gonna turn it off now. So you see all the juice that the fruits have produced? We aren't gonna use all of the juice. We're actually gonna take most of the fruit out, and we're gonna put it inside of a bowl to let it, you know, cool off a bit before we put it in the blender. And we're gonna see what it's hitting for. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the fruits and use a strainer spoon. And we're gonna make sure all of the fruit, I'm taking the fruits and we're gonna pour it. Draining them. It smells so good. I just wanna really bite it, honestly. So you see there's a little bit of juice. Well, there's a lot of juice left. We're going to take a little bit of that juice and pour it in there. Just a little. Now, we let it cool. Let it cool off a bit. Here it goes. Here's how it looks. Woo! I think it smells good. Now we're going to put the strawberries and berries on the stove. We have the strawberries and the berries waiting and simmering. So I did not wash out the pan, you guys. I want to let you guys know that I did leave the residue of the juice in there. So I just used the leftover juice puree. So it's going to probably have a little banana taste in it, but I kind of wanted to, you know, leave that there for her. I'm really hoping that she likes bananas. You know, bananas is good for you. And Genesis, she does have like a little gassy, you know, she's always backed up a little. So hopefully this helps her go. Trying to give her a natural probiotic. Guess who's back and up and back? Hey, G. Let me see, mommy. Say hi, G. Hey, say I'm up. You're up, mommy. I wish I could just let her try it, but it's still hot, so. Okay, here we go. Now we're back in action. Now we're back with mommy and G. Let's get it, G. Bobby, while we wait for the food. This is what me and Judy do all day. We play, laugh. We talk, mommy, right? You telling him? Are you ready for this food, G?
You ready?
You don't even know it's about to hit you, girl. You don't know it's about to hit you, baby. It's about to change your life. This food about to change your life. Yeah, I'm so excited for her to eat. Okay, let's check over. So the only thing I hate about being in the kitchen with G is, like, I don't like being near the stove with her. I don't know, even though I'm careful, I just don't like it. Don't like it. I would rather not, mommy. But this is my sidekick, right? Actually, I call G my shadow. This is my shadow. Hey, shadow. Hey, mommy. Okay, now we're gonna blend G. You ready, mommy? Okay. I hope this isn't so loud. I hope it doesn't really startle her. Let's get it. So, I am gonna try to one-hand it because I just like hate reaching over her, especially with hot things. So, when you become a mom, you gotta learn how to multitask. I was really never good at multitasking, but I could teach you a thing or two now. Okay. Okay, shake that off a bit, and we're gonna take the rest and just empty it in there, G. Yeah, G. Okay. This is gonna be our first time. Oh, yo, that would have been so bad. So I didn't know that you twisted on there. I thought it was a button. Wow. Woo, thank God, because that would have been so bad. It would have been all in G's hair. Wow. Okay, wait, let me be careful. Okay. Let me back this up. Let me not do this on top of there. How about that? Let's do that, G. Let's do that, mommy. Okay, so we got it on there. Now we can twist it. Ready? Okay. Okay, so I pureed it for about, honestly, like 30 seconds. And as you can see, let's see it. It's still hot. So our baby Billy did come with a storage kit, you know, a little cup to put your stuff in. And also these, I guess these are feeding tubes, I think. I'm pretty sure because like they have the date on there and everything. Yeah, we're going to do a review on this magic bullet. I keep calling the magic bullet. We're going to do a review on this baby budget. I said baby budget. Baby bullet, G. Because it's lit, mommy. Look at these. They got the date on it when you twist it. Oh, yeah. That's cool. Okay. Anywho, back to it. So, we're going to take our puree. And I'm going to use... I don't think these storage containers are big enough for the food that I made for Genesis. So, what I'm going to do is... Hey, Gigi. Yeah, she's still pretty sleepy. So, I'm probably going to have to... You know, put her back to sleep because she's fighting it. I can see it in her eyes. That baby's tired. But what I am going to do is I'm going to take three of the cups and I'm going to put half of the banana, apple, and strawberry puree in these three because it comes with six, and I'm going to put the other strawberry puree. We're going to call it the Berry Blast Puree, G. Yeah, Gigi. We're going to call it the Berry Blast, mommy. So we're going to do the same thing with the Berry Blast. That's what we call it, right, G? We're going to make sure we take the berries. We put them in the bowl. Let's get it, G. Here we go. Look at these. It doesn't smell better than the other puree. Woo. The other puree. I think the apples did it. The apple smell done set it off. But we're going to take a little bit of the juices again and use it. We're going to use all of the solids in here because I almost left some now. You're trying to feed Gigi, get her nice and healthy, right, mommy? Yeah. Get it, of course, and we're going to put it in the bullet. We're gonna put it in the bullet, G. in the village. Okay. So the berries didn't take long at all. What did we grind that up for? About 20 seconds. So here we go. And now Gigi has her berry blast. Puree, yay! Look at her trying to see it, y'all. Hopefully she likes it. Oh my gosh! 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 Look at this crap.
Did you get her hairbrush?
What should I do?
I don't put the strawberry puree in your hair. Do strawberries help your hair grow?
Look at the drop in my baby hair. Oh, poor G. I'm sorry, baby. Now I gotta wash her hair. I mean, nah, I ain't never really hit nobody putting fruit in their hair. I was about to lie. I told you guys I'm gonna put half of the fruit in here, so this will be a feeding. This will be one feeding for her, hopefully, like, you know, if she eats it. So it's Genesis feeding time, you guys. She'll be right back. So I'm gonna fill these up to feed her. I feel like, you know, I don't want to overdo it and fill it up too much. There we go. Okay, I am done, y'all. We got the puree in here. This one, again, is the apples, bananas, and the strawberries. And this one is the berry blast. This one is berries, strawberries, raspberries, and blueberries. And of course, you know, I put them in their little storage container. Look how cute they are. Oh, I can't wait to feed her. Wait, y'all gotta get the smile. You gotta catch the smiley face. Hold up. Hold up. Catch the smiley. Hold, they all gotta be smiling. Hold up. We about to feed G. Hold up. Look at that. Yeah. So that is all, you guys. And of course, I'm gonna give you a little sneak peek on how she liked it. Can't wait for her first feeding. Hey, you ready to try the food, mommy? Yes or no?
Yes or no?
Okay, she don't got nothing to say. All right. All right. Okay, G's up from her nap. So we're going to try both of the foods. I don't know which one to give her today. Which one, G? Choose which one, mommy. Okay. See if she just choosing that hand. Let's see. Okay, she just choosing this hand. Okay. So we're gonna do a taste test instead. We're gonna let Genesis choose. Ooh, I'm excited. Y'all ready? Y'all ready? Y'all ready? Y'all ready? So I had this cooling in the fridge for about, I mean, 40 minutes. It's the, what did I call it? The berry blast. I forgot already, G. This is your berry blast, G. Ready? Excuse me. Can I try? Let's see your face. You like, okay. Hello? You like that? Hello? Okay, first spoonful. Oh! I don't know what that was. Oh. Is this good or bad, y'all? I think she liking it or no. I'm confused. Let's try this one now. This is the strawberries, apples, and bananas. Oh yeah. This one smells so good. You ready? You can get some of this. Let's see. Oh, she swallowed. Let me see. Oh no, y'all, this is confusing. Why she keep doing that? Are you okay? You okay? You like it? Let's see. Turn me on some most on my haters. What am I torturing her, Lauren?
What's the scent of strawberries?
This is strawberries in here.
Yeah, it's the strawberries. The shankiness.
Both of them. And always have the baby wipes on deck.
Yeah.
And ready.
accidents do happen.
Turn me on some more. I don't know
which one she likes. I would say I'm gonna Google it, but y'all remember my last experience with Google Genesis, so we're not gonna go there. Yeah, G, we're not gonna. Yeah, I'm pretty sure she likes the food, but you know, the texture and taste is a little different. G, tell him you like it, mommy. Genesis, G, do you like it, G? Is it a thumbs up or a thumbs down, mommy? G, you like it? Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no, mommy? Yes or no, Stinky? Okay, I don't know yet. But, G, tell him what to do, G. Tell him what to do, G. Tell him to like, share, and subscribe, baby. Tell him to comment any recipes that they have for you, mommy. Right? We're in stage one of baby food, so most of the baby foods right now is pureed. Look, it looks like she's reaching for it. Genesis, I thought you was eating. Oh. You good? I thought you was eating.
I made it look like.
Thank you guys for tuning in to the first episode of Mommy and G. Of course, it was her first feeding. This was so special to me. First time making her baby food. Follow me on this baby food journey because I will be looking up more recipes.